everyone. I'm Stephanie Hamill. Welcome to In Focus. So the White House confirmed that the U.S. will participate in a diplomatic boycott of the 2022 Beijing Winter Olympics, and this is due to China's human rights atrocities. Listen.
The administration will not send any diplomatic or official representation to the Beijing 2022 Winter Olympics and Paralympic Games, given the PRC's ongoing genocide and crimes against humanity in Xinjiang and other human rights abuses. The athletes on Team USA have our full support. We will be behind them 100% as we cheer them on from home, but we will not be contributing to the fanfare of the Games. U.S. diplomatic or official representation would treat these games as business as usual in the face of the PRC's egregious human rights abuses and atrocities in Xinjiang, and we simply can't do that. As the president has told President Xi, standing up for human rights is in the DNA of Americans. We have a fundamental commitment to promoting human rights, and we feel strongly in our position, and we will continue to take actions to advance human rights in China and beyond.
Now, China is already threatening the U.S. over the decision. At a news conference, the ministry spokesperson Zhao Lijian said this, quote, out of ideological bias and based on lies and rumors, the U.S. is trying to disrupt the Beijing Winter Olympics. This will only expose its sinister intention and further erode its moral authority and credibility. Now, he went on to say, the wrong move of the U.S. has undermined the foundation and atmosphere for China-U.S. sports exchanges and Olympic cooperation. It has shot itself in the foot. The U.S. should understand the grave consequences of its move. Now, just to be clear, the decision does not extend to U.S. athletes who will still be allowed to compete in the games. So that being said, does Team Biden's decision go far enough? Also, is it safe for American athletes to participate? Join me now to weigh in, representing South Carolina's 3rd District, Congressman Jeff Duncan. Congressman, thank you so much for joining me. So, Congressman, I'll ask you, do you think this goes far enough?
Well, first off, I'm glad they're doing something. A diplomatic boycott is fine, but I don't believe it goes far enough. I would love to see a total boycott with our athletes as well. But this president doesn't have the resolve that Jimmy Carter had with the 1980 boycott. And so we're going to send our athletes over there. If we're going to do that and not stand up for human rights abuses, not stand with the Uyghurs, if our athletes do go over there, I hope they have a Jesse Owens moment. I hope they win all the sports that they participate in and show the communists that Americans are strong.
Yeah, I agree with you that I appreciate this move. At least something is being done. That being said, there just aren't enough people with platforms that are speaking out against the atrocities happening in China. But I will give credit where credit is due. And once in a while, some in the mainstream media get it right. We even heard from Jake Tapper, who is calling out the administration for being weak on China. We have video roll tape.
That Simpsons episode in Hong Kong disappeared like Peng Shui, disappeared like citizen journalist Zhang Zhan, whom the Chinese government has locked up for telling the truth about COVID-19, disappeared. Like the consciences of the millionaires and billionaires in Hollywood and the NBA and the IOC and Wall Street are all so eager for Chinese cash, they are pretending none of this is happening. There is no amount of money that can buy enough soap to wash that blood off their hands.
Now, he's right. I mean, you got to follow the money trail here.
Yeah, I'm really glad to see Jake Tapper do that, and applaud him for speaking out. You know, I think about the Celtics basketball player who stood up against the NBA and actually stands for freedom, understands what's happening, the Uyghur people there, human rights abuses. He stands for freedom. That's a shining example of what we should be doing as a nation to stand up against any human rights abuses.
And then what about COVID-19 and the origins of the virus in the Wuhan lab? You know, it's still yet people are turning a blind eye to what China knew when they knew it, what happened in the Wuhan lab, and nobody's been held accountable for that either.
And they should be. I mean, even Dr. Fauci called it a Wuhan strain recently, but Donald Trump was vilified for using the term Chinese virus or Wuhan virus. And look, we have a history of naming things for where the virus has come from, whether it's Zika or Ebola or West Nile virus or even MERS, all are named from where they come from. But yet Trump was vilified. Now Fauci has said that. And look, we know Rand Paul has pointed this out, and I applaud him for this. We know that your tax dollars, American tax dollars, were given to China, given to the Wuhan lab. lab for gain-of-function research to create this virus that escaped. Whether it was intentional or unintentional, it did escape. It started in Wuhan, and we need to acknowledge that. And China needs to be open about this, and we need to solve this COVID-19 crisis and put this pandemic to bed. I think if China was more a willing participant in helping the world, not just the United States, in addressing the Wuhan virus, then we could actually put this pandemic to bed.
Yeah. We actually have a video clip of Dr. Fauci calling the Wuhan virus, and it is interesting because originally when President Trump or any of us called the Wuhan virus, we were called racist. And so to hear it out of Fauci's mouth again was kind of surprising. So let's take a look and we'll react after. Roll tape.
Is that if you look at the vaccination, we were vaccinated against the original, what we call ancestral or Wuhan strain.
So again, when Trump says it or Republicans say it, it's racist. But if Dr. Fauci says it, I guess it's okay.
Yeah, you know, Dr. Fauci helped support the gain-of-function research. He has some direct responsibility. He needs to quit lying to the American people, quit lying to Congress, come clean about this, and quit trying to control the American people with vaccine mandates and then vaccine passports to travel domestically is what the administration wants to do. This is wrong. This is control. It's federal overreach. Dr. Fauci has been given way too much power, and I think he has misled not only the American people, but the United States Congress, and he needs to be held accountable for that.
You and some other members of Congress, some Republicans, including Congressman Ralph Norman, you guys are demanding that the FDA release COVID vaccine data in 100 days. Originally, the FDA had requested 55 years to hand over that information relating to the coronavirus vaccines. 55 years.
Yeah, I mean, I hate to laugh. It's just ludicrous. A vaccine that took 108 days to develop, the vaccine that's being put in the arms of Americans to try to stop the pandemic, but yet they want to hide that data for 55 years. If it smells like a fish, it probably is a fish, and this is an example of that. This doesn't smell right. It doesn't smell right to the American people, and it definitely doesn't smell right to members of Congress. So we're asking them to release that data in the same time frame that they created the vaccine, 108 days. 100 days is what Ralph has in his bill. Let's show the American people what's in the vaccine that they're having to inject because of the mandates of the administration. In many cases, they're having to inject in their body. And let me just say this, Stephanie, that no one should have to worry about their job. Taking an injection of a vaccine like this should not be a condition of employment, period. But we're seeing the Biden administration force this on agencies, federal government employees, and federal government contractors, like people that work at the Savannah River site there in South Carolina, the military, people that are in top physical shape that aren't fearful of the COVID-19 Wuhan virus, but they don't want to inject their body with something that was developed so quickly in 108 days without all the clinical trials and studies that we normally do for any sort of vaccine or inoculation. And so this thing was rushed. And it looks to me like the COVID-19 virus is starting to dissipate a little bit. We see the Omicron virus, which is very mild, but we're going to shut down travel over a very, very mild form of this that hadn't hospitalized people. And we don't know of any deaths, to my knowledge, that have come from that. But we're going to use that as justification for a further lockdown of our economy and our travel. It's just wrong. It just shows the administration using this as a control feature.
Yeah, and you pointed out something really important here is these new travel restrictions. And so the government is asking Americans to do what they're not even asking illegal border crossers to do. No one's testing those who are coming over across the border illegally. And they're not being asked to be vaccinated before they're transported into the interior of the country. And so it's really hard to take some of these officials, whether it be politicians or health experts, when they're completely silent on what's going on at the border. If we're dealing with a pandemic, then we better treat it like a pandemic.
You're exactly right. I mean, we have no idea, A, who's in our country, because you only hear of apprehension rates. We don't hear about all the numbers that have actually gotten across the border that we don't know about, that weren't apprehended by the little bit of enforcement effort that the Biden administration is trying to do along the border. And then the ones that are apprehended by CBP and ICE, they're released in the interior of the country without a COVID test, without a COVID vaccination. Many of them are bringing other diseases that we have tamped down in this country. There's fear of TB. There's fear of measles and other things. So the The question I have is, why does the Biden administration have to put on planes in the middle of the night and fly them to places like Florida and Illinois and Michigan and maybe South Carolina? Who knows where they're taking these people in the middle of the night with midnight flights? That shows that something's wrong as well.
Yeah, definitely something's wrong here. Well, Congressman, we appreciate you. Thank you so much for joining us on the show.
Stephanie, thank you so much.
Of course.